believe that some of the things that I'm about to say is what I want to do. And that's why I'm looking forward to being with Jesus to be together. Because that's what it is. There are all good things that never end. Let me talk about the healing of God.
your plans are, it's gone. It cannot be retracted. It's gone. Your strategy, you die to do that. Instead, he's referring to the power that's left. And he's thinking and deciding how we can use God by suggesting that the rest of our time to be used for redemptive purposes. But that's the only way we can make the most of the power that is left. Whatever that purpose is, this is it. It is important that we learn what measure of time is left, but in depth, not in one decree, but in strategy. In other words, our concern should not be how long we live, rather it should be how better we live. Because we don't know and will never know how long we can live. So, worrying over that is not only foolish, but it's also stupid. What is the one most to us is what we do with the present moment, how we use the opportunity that we are given to allow. Without Jesus. And there is no quality living without Jesus Christ. Because the Bible says, He has passed the first and now eternal life, born of God. The saints have already begun the quality of eternal life. It doesn't mean that the one now, He's not talking about the length of time, but the quality of life. We can begin to live the life of heaven and earth because 2,000 years ago, heaven came down and glory filled our soul. I didn't know how to live and enjoy life until I met Jesus. And He delivered me from the temptation of life. The frustrating way there is not no food left to draw. Peace and hope in the way the world is. Because it is the world is walking and it's riding down a dead end street. Unless they turn around, there is no way out. I thank God that Jesus sent His blood to deliver us from that futile way of living of life. And now He is granting us quality living. Someone once said that life is a book of three volumes: the present and the yet to come. The third volume is wrong from that. And God holds it in. We don't know who holds the future. So we don't know what the future holds. But we do know who holds the future. If you have a doubt, if you have a doubt that sets your account with $86,400 every month, it carries over your boundaries from day to day and allows you to keep your past in your account. And finally, it stands for any account, any amount you fail to use during the day. What would you do? I am sure this is why. $86,400, I am sure you will go to your bank every morning and withdraw every cent of faith into them. Well, today, I'm telling you that you will not talk about it. And that is your time. Every morning, it sends you with 86,400 cents. 60 by 60 by 24. Every night, it's will result of love. Enter your prayers and death to God's good purpose. If there is no crisis and the house no crisis, it doesn't allow any overflow. Each day, the night is done. The night man opens the door down. This means each night is turned to the record of the day to history. If you fail to do the day of his promise, wisely, the walk to yours eternally. Now, God's suffering is one of the greatest gifts God has given to us. The eyes for the meaning to share with all the time to live in. That's why the fortune of God is a possible is a song with possibility. And you might say, I'm not willing to cause a trial of most stretching out. So this time is over. So far we have a story to finish. What are we doing? With the time that God is in your family. Let's see if you can learn the essence from how Jesus knew God. John 9 1. John 9 1. This is the Bible. I'm telling a story today, but as Jesus passed the bus, he saw a man who was blind from his birth. As you know that story, right? And the disciples asked him, Master, who is this man of sin that you should be born of? Jesus answered, we are six man's sisters of a spirit. But by the works of God, to be manifest in him. I have to walk the world for him who sent me by the day, the night for them, but no man can work. It is easy for us to raise God with easiness structure. Structures are inappropriate and unimportant. Sometimes we miss the point. Why? We are here. Sometimes we think, we act, we speak, we relate to others like the rest of the world. Without a mission and without a hope, sometimes we live as if Jesus never lived, as if he never passed, and we often behave as if he is coming again. We waste so much time filtering the mind, pulling around with your unnecessary when you should be sucking the lives of others with eternal justice. We meet people every day and we don't know whether we will meet them again. Therefore, our business is important. Our business to be that the sucking the lives of everyone we meet with a gospel, with a holy consumer. We are living in the end time. In the last day, when things all around us are falling up and falling apart, the world is not a few ones. Man's public iniquity is almost full to the overflow. He's disappointed to preach the word. I believe that God's people come to the time when we must be sober, when we must be vigilant. Just as Paul says, we must cast off the works of darkness and the force of the flesh and put on the whole armor of light. In John 9 1, here, what he said to me, get your ready for the reason for the man of his life. Here was a blind man who needed your help, and here I am, speaking to Jesus. Oh, so much better. Long. God. He has tried four times and he has tried. So he will not to lift those hands again. You wish you were there. You wish those footsteps had come again. You know what I'm talking about? It's wishing for something that is just never found. Thank you. Jesus.